Today's World Watch is sponsored by Summit Ministries. Experience a summer of growth, form lifelong friendships, and confidently engage culture.
Good morning. It's Monday, February 14th. Happy Valentine's Day, honey. Hope you're having a good one. And now with Top Story. Well, thanks for joining us, everybody. Don't pass up the opportunity to watch our full World Watch Show 2. Among the day's news stories, I'll tell you about an ancient road discovered in Berlin, and Hannah Harris will crack the case of the Ponzi scheme in another installment of What in the Word. Now, here's Top Story. Watch this, a scientific breakthrough. Did you see it? Over in a flash. British scientists last week announced that they had smashed the record for generating sustained nuclear fusion energy.
We overcame one hurdle after another to produce a sustained fusion plasma that released 59 megajoules of fusion energy in a 5-second pulse.
That's double the previous record, and researchers say a milestone on a path towards harnessing nuclear fusion as a power source. The demonstration shows promise because if they can maintain the energy for 5 seconds, they likely could sustain it for longer, which is the only way it could ever become a viable power source. Years of experiments are still ahead. What is nuclear fusion and how does the testing work? Reporter Michelle Slavin will explain after the break.
Harnessing the power of the sun and other stars. It sounds like science fiction, but researchers have already replicated the heat-generating process to a small degree using nuclear fusion.
Fission and fusion are different processes. Fission is taking a large atom and splitting it apart. Fusion is taking two small atoms and putting them together.
This fusing reaction releases energy. When you hear the word nuclear, you might picture this, or this. Nuclear fission is often questioned for its destructive power and potential for catastrophic accidents.
In terms of the practicality of building a power plant, yeah, fusion has a number of advantages. It's much more inherently safe. The fuel is more abundant, there's fewer concerns with radioactive waste and so on.
So scientists were excited last week to reach a milestone, sustaining 5 seconds of fusion energy. Their tests were carried out in a donut-shaped machine called tokamak. In this vacuum chamber, researchers are trying to replicate the conditions at the core of the sun, where fusion reactions occur naturally. Put simply, they need lots of heat and pressure. Inside the tokamak, there's a tiny amount of fuel made up of two hydrogen isotopes, deuterium, which can be found in seawater, and tritium, which is radioactive and limited in supply. The fuel is heated to temps 10 times hotter than the center of the sun, creating what's called plasma. Some call this the honorary fourth state of matter. This plasma is then held in place using superconductor electromagnets as it spins around, fuses, and releases tremendous energy as heat. But the real test?
We still need to show that we can produce more energy from fusion than we take to actually start the experiment.
So while fusion shows great promise, it's still a long way from being a viable energy source.
Take a moment to like and subscribe to our channel below, and then make sure to check out the full site at worldwatch.news. You can actually try out the show free for a month. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. I'm the Big Bash. Remember, whatever the news, the purpose of the Lord will stand.